show is brought to you by the Coca-Cola Bottling Company of North Texas. Coca-Cola Classic. Can't beat the feeling. Radio Shack, the technology store, America's leader in consumer electronics. Blackman Mooring Stomatic, carpet, furniture, drapery, and air duct cleaning. Delta Airlines. Delta, we love to fly, and it shows. Dr. Pepper Bottling Company of Texas. Dr. Pepper and TCU, just what the doctor ordered. Jack Williams Auto Mall, Highway 80 at Loop 820 and West Fort Worth. Ashworth Insurance, for your peace of mind, we're always there. TCU would also like to thank the following sponsors for their support. Max Eubank Roofing, Bruce Alford, Union Pacific Resources, Curtis Nooner, and Southwest Land Title.
Great effort by the Horned Frogs, but they come up a little shy tonight against a great football team. The final score, Arkansas 41, TCU 19.
Man, what an ugly, depressing sight to see all those walking wounded coming out at halftime. Hey, if I had seen that group before the ball game, if I'd have known how many great players we had that weren't going to be able to perform, I'll tell you what, I might have gone in for treatment and training wheels at halftime. But hey, what did happen, what really did happen, is a lot of young football players came to play. And a lot of guys strapped it on, and we took the number 7 team in the nation down to the wire for 3 quarters. And we played them as good as we could play, as hard as we could play, and I'm awfully proud of them from that standpoint. But hey, finally, it took its toll. Finally, guys like Fred Washington and so on, 5 starters out of the lineup on defense, 3 of our best players in offense on the bench, didn't play the entire ball game. That finally took its toll. That's going to happen sometime. All of a sudden, their line came off the ball. Give credit to Arkansas. Boy, Ken Hatfield, the staff, did a great job. And they finally did knock us back, and they did wear us down. And they finally did break some big, big plays.
2nd and 7 from the 44. Grovey on the option, throws it over the middle to Horton. Caught at the 30, down to the 25, down to the 23. Slant into Horton. He is deadly. And they have receivers left and right. An eye formation on 2nd down and 8. Handoff. This is Big Juju Harshaw, a load. Hopping on for a ride is Reggie Campbell, all the way down to the 35. A first down. Here's a first down from the 23-yard line. Here's Harshaw, right tackle. Harshaw breaks through. Harshaw to the 5. Touchdown, Juju Harshaw from 23 yards out. Broke at least 2 tackles, and the Razorbacks now lead by 2 touchdowns. Here's a 3rd and 3 at the 34. Far hash mark. Grovey runs the option. Grovey's deadly. Has the first down out to the 45, 50. One man to beat to the 40, 35. 30, the 28-yard line, and Britton finally angles him out of bounds. Well, TCU slapped. Now Arkansas trying to slap back. Foster, big hole at left tackle, and he goes in easily. Touchdown, Arkansas. And here is a 2nd down and about 7. TCU into the field. Handoff, new back this time, and he is a scampering inside the 35, 30, down to the 29-yard line. Kerwin Price. 1st down and 10 at the 18-yard line. Williams, draw play. This is Ron Dickerson. Dickerson inside the 10 to the 5. Touchdown, Arkansas.
Yes, 4-yard rushing. That young man's grown up, and he's grown up in a hurry. Boy, is he playing right now. What about some of the others, huh? Tommy Palmer, another outstanding game there. About 100 yards in tandem offense, rushing and receiving. And you know, a really amazing statistic? In the 2nd half, we had 11 guys catch passes, and all 11 passes were caught by freshmen. Guys like Shipley, Nowak, Houston, Modkin, and Jackson. Hey, a lot of young players are playing awfully, awfully well for the Horned Frogs. And hallelujah, only 1 turnover.
2nd and 5. 2 receivers right, including Stephen Shipley. The setback right is Jackson. Handoff, deep backfield. It's Tommy Palmer. Past the 30, out to the 35. 1st down for Tommy Palmer. Dickens and Beret split wide right. Short drop. They hit Jackson downfield at the 45, and he's near midfield for another 1st down. Well, Arkansas has 4 defensive backs in the ballgame. TCU has 2 receivers left, 1 right. Giles to throw. blitz coming. They blitz six, but they dump the screen to Palmer. He scored on this play last week. To the 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Tommy Palmer. From 49 yards out, and TCU is on the board. Tommy Palmer is in the backfield alone on first and 10 at the 23. Takes the handoff, weaves his way out past the 30-yard line to the 34. So it's second and 20 at the 23-yard line. Near hash mark, Giles straight drop this time. Four-man rush, looking near side. Arcs it out to the 32, and Michael Jackson is there to get the catch. They send Shipley wide right, along with Holmes. Slotted right, Jackson. Draw play, Palmer from the 20. Inside the 15, or about the 15-yard line. We've got Giles 5 of 11 through the air, third and 9 from the 30-yard line. He wants to throw. Throws a screen to Curtis Motkins. Motkins out past the 35, 40, and a first down. And this is a third and 7. 7:49 to go in the third. 43-yard line. Giles fakes to Motkins, rolls out.
There he is.
Looking sideline. Has his man. First down catch at the 48 of Arkansas by Mike Nowak. Third and 6. The lone setback is Motkins. Two receivers right. Giles is looking that way as he rolls out. Throws and hits Shipley at the 32. Diving catch by Shipley near the right hash mark. First down, TCU.
Steve, that's the third time on third down. As you were saying, they've converted with a big pass play. First and 10 at the Arkansas 34. Giles looking, plenty of time. Throws flat-footed to Nowak. Caught at the 20. Down to the 14-yard line.
Mike Bull of the center. Getting ready to snap it to Giles, who sends Palmer to a slot left. Giles with a 5-yard drop. He's under pressure. Scrambles. Hits Nowak at the 40, 41-yard line near a first down. 13-13 at the end of three, but two fourth-quarter touchdowns are one near the end of the third, and then this touchdown by Harshaw makes it 27-13. Here's Giles to throw. Wide open in Arkansas territory at the 40-yard line as Giles rifles it to Steve Shipley. Over 11 minutes to go in this game. Ball in the middle of the field. Short drop, and they hit him on the quick shot. Giles to Jackson down to the 32-yard line. Gain of 8. Lone setback is Palmer. Two receivers right, one left. It's Todd Holmes. Hand off Palmer. Palmer at the 30, down to the 25, 20 to the 16-yard line. Palmer with a big gainer. Third and 9. Two receivers right, including Stephen Shipley and Michael Jackson. Giles rolls left, now rolls right, under pressure, throws it up. Michael Jackson is there, one-hands it, 8 yards deep in the end zone, a touchdown for the Horned Frogs. Yes! First and 10 at the 28, Giles under pressure. At the last moment, he delivers the ball over the middle to Nowak, not much available. Here's a second and 7 from the 31. Giles to throw. Rifles it over the middle. Caught by Jackson. First down out to the 46. Don't tell Giles this game is over. He's still firing away, and that's a first down for the Horned Frogs. First and 10 at their own 47. In motion, they send Michael Jackson. The lone setback is Palmer. Giles is rolling left. Giles tucks it at the 50 down to the 46-yard line. A gain of 7 for Ron Giles.
Fight, fight, fight.
Hey, you look at those films. There were a lot of guys that played really hard. And we did, at times, really play good defense, particularly in those first 3 quarters.
Jordy Reynolds is in there at middle linebacker right now. TCU trying to make some adjustments. Third down, blitz coming. They pick it up. Here's Darrell Davis coming from the outside to get the sack with help from a blitzing Steve Conley all the way back at the 23-yard line. Second down and 10. They pitch left. Dickerson almost lost the handle again. Finally got it, but Darrell Davis got him a yard deep in the backfield as they try the left side, and now it's third down at the 42-yard line. A change into the field for the second quarter. It's third and 10. Moving right to left, the Hogs from their own 42. Play action fake to Harshaw. Groby in trouble. Chased out of the pocket. He gets the ball away, and it's intercepted in midfield by TCU down the sideline. Goes Charles Britton all the way to the 21-yard line. Second and 7. Receivers Russell and Horton split left and right, respectively. The lone setback is Rouse, and they pitch it to him, but there to meet him was Greg Moore for a loss of 1 back to the 19-yard line. TCU rushes four. Davis standing up at a defensive end from the outside, and Marsh makes the sack. Davis caused Williams to take it up the middle, and Marsh was there to clean up. And so a new safety in there for TCU. First and goal, double tight ends. Arkansas play action fake, and Williams slips at the 15-yard line. He saw Greg Moore coming from the outside, and Williams tried to cut back and couldn't, lose his five. Reggie Campbell, a redshirt freshman, in there in place of Crump. It's second down and goal from the 15. Blitz coming from the outside, and the ball is loose. Moore hit it. Ball loose at the 23, and Williams fell on it. Wide left, Russell. The tight end, Winston, set up left side. Rouse, the setback behind Harshaw, the fullback, and Harshaw gets the carry and goes to the 15-yard line from the 17 on first down. Second down and eight with 52 seconds left. They send a man in motion near side, the short side, and give it to Rouse. Rouse hit in the backfield, but gets a couple of yards anyway.
8 seconds, 7 seconds. They're going to go ahead and try and pick up the first down.
Todd Wright was lined up in a field goal formation. He shifted into a slot. They hand it to Harshaw. Harshaw at left tackle, very close, depending on the spot of the football, from the 28-yard line. Far side, the short side. Arkansas in their road, white with the red helmets. Hand off, here's Barry Foster, blasted at the line of scrimmage by the middle of that defensive line for TCU. And here is a third down and nine. They run the reverse. Russell in trouble at the 20, gets away from Collins, gets away from Conley, but not away from Cobble and Campbell. Arkansas first and 10 at their own 33-yard line. Pitched around, coming left, strung out, and tackled by McWright and Cobble for a gain of nothing. And our score is close here, 13-10 Arkansas, third down and eight. Groby to throw, hit as he throws, throws. McWright almost picked it off in front of Tim Horton at the 48-yard line, near sideline.
Talk about walk-ons. Hey, we've got the world's oldest walk-on, Rex Roberts, our punter. What a night he had, huh? 40 over 45-yard average per kick, and I mean, I'm so proud of that guy. But what about all those other walk-ons that have paid such a price, that have worked so hard? What about guys like our starting weak linebacker, Will Linebacker, Jason Cobble? He's as tough a fighter and a competitor as we have on this football team. Boy, am I proud of him. And other guys, how many of those guys on specialty teams? Guys like a Don Casas, huh? Todd Orsak, Scott McKinney, Jason Chilton. Man, they are making some of the key blocks, some of the big plays, making things happen, and our specialty teams really played well. A lot of that was because of Walker.
Well, it's unique in the sense that, it costs young men an awful lot of money to come to school here. It's about $10,000, $11,000 a year. And a lot of those kids have to make a lot of sacrifices to afford to come to school like TCU, hoping that they can maybe earn a scholarship once they get here.
Well, it's all right. Riding around in the
I'd hoped to get a scholarship to a Division I football school, but it didn't work out, so I just pursued it as a walk-on, and so that's enabled me to go on and play.
It's frustrating to go from a high school star to a college nobody, and it's tough on us. It really is.
My parents love TCU, and figured it'd be a good experience for me to walk on and see personally how I could do, and if I didn't do well, though, at least I'd give it a shot.
I felt like I had a chance, and that's all I wanted. And, everyone coming out of high school, whether you're a walk-on or not, for the most part, is going to, have some uneasy feelings coming into it. And, I just thought if I gave it my best shot and worked as hard as I could, then I, would have the greatest chance possible to get in here and play. And I always felt like I could play, and it's just the hard work's paid off.
You can sit around and wait for the phone to ring, waiting for someone to tell you everything. Sit around and wonder what tomorrow will bring. Maybe a diamond ring.
a walk-on, you know, you just got to work hard each day, you know, because you're underrated. You got to prove to them and prove to yourself that you can do it. And it's hard coming out, being a walk-on, and think, man, I'm paying for this, getting hit, beat up every day. But, you know, I'm sure that if you work hard, it's going to pay off.
It's definitely worth the work. You know, I was in a no-lose situation coming off my fifth year. Finished up my 4 years of eligibility playing soccer, or the first 4 years. And so I had a semester left, and I figured, you know, I had nothing to lose. So last spring, I walked into Wacker's office and said, you know, I want to give it a shot kicking. And he said, well, come on.
That day I walked into Coach Wacker's office, and I sat down, and he was going through the spring training and how well I did. And he finally told me that I had earned a full scholarship. And I was just so happy. I didn't know if I should go up and hug him or, you know, just cry or do what, but it was a great feeling.
It's all right. Remember to live and it lives well. It's all right. The best you can do is forgive. Well, it's all right.
Walk-ons are here more or less on their own time, and you just have to fight through that and you know, believe in yourself, and it's a lot of hard work.
Well, too, what about Kevin Cordesman? Boy, he boomed those kickoffs, gave us great coverage. We held Arkansas to right at 10 yards per return on the kickoff. That's outstanding. He also hit two big, big field goals, one a 43-yarder, and hey, what about Charles Britton, huh? Almost 22 yards, over 22 yards to return on those kickoff returns. He's getting better every week. Thank goodness, offense and specialty teams came and they played the entire ball game.
Here's Rex Roberts punting for the third time, standing at his own 8, got off a 45-yarder the last time, and he booms another one. Horton all the way back to the 30. Gets past the first guy, but TCU is there to bring him down after a 2-yard gain. Tunji Bolden rats him up there. Stands at his own 8-yard line. Had a good punting first half and gets a nice kick away again. This ball turns over at the 50 and is caught by Horton down at the 31-yard line. Another nice punt of 49 yards by Roberts. Nowak to hold, Black to snap. Big one to tie the football game. Long count, Black snap, Nowak's hold. Cordesman's kick is on the way, and it's good from 43 yards out, and TCU has tied the ball game at 13. It's Arkansas 20, TCU 13, with 35 seconds left to go in the third quarter following the Juju Harshaw touchdown, and Glenn Ray Hines, the son of a former Houston Oiler, kicks off to Charles Britton at the 5. Back to the 15, 20, cuts up this way to the 25, 30, and driven out of bounds at the 34-yard line.
Okay, we had our chance. We had our chance to knock off the number 7 ranked team in the nation. For three quarters, it looked awfully good, then we blew it. I mean, they came out and they dominated. It's over. Forget it. It's done with. Now it happens to be the Rice Owls. Now we have to go to Houston and play one of the most improved teams in the Southwest Conference. What a great job Fred Goldsmith and his staff there have done putting that team together. And hey, man, Donald Hollis, he's throwing the ball all over the field. He is one of the most exciting, one of the most dominating players in the conference right now. They're a fine football team. And these old young Horned Frogs better strap it on. We better get ready. I believe we'll do that. I believe we're going to get a great effort again this Saturday. It should be a great ball game. We hope some of you can come there and give us great, great support. We need it.
When somebody plays at the end of the line, the purple haze. Well, it's all right. Even when push comes to shove. Well, it's all right. If you got someone to love. Well, it's all right.
All right. happy to feel that.
At the end of the line,
and it don't matter if you're by my side.